In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water He has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May He help us by His grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Let us pray. Almighty and God, Heavenly Father, who art the source and origin of all life, whether of body or soul, we ask you to bless this water which we use in confidence to implore forgiveness for our sins and to obtain the protection of your grace against all illness and every snare of the enemy. Grant, O Lord, in your mercy, that living waters may always spring up for our salvation, and so may we approach you with a pure heart and avoid all danger to body and soul, through Christ our Lord. Amen. We humbly ask you, Lord Almighty God, to be pleased in your faithful love to bless the salt you have created, for it was you who commanded the prophet Elisha to cast salt into water that impure water might be purified. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that wherever this mixture of salt and water is sprinkled, every attack of the enemy may be repulsed and your Holy Spirit may be present to keep us safe at all times, through Christ our Lord.
We'll be singing number 647, Come to the River, for the sprinkling rite.
Almighty God, cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, may make us worthy to share at the table of His kingdom. Amen.
We give you
Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, who when Christ has been baptized in the river Jordan, and as the Holy Spirit descended upon him, solemnly declared him your beloved Son, grant that your children by adoption, reborn of water and the Holy Spirit, may always be well pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen one with whom I am pleased, upon whom I have put my spirit. He shall bring forth justice to the nations, not crying out, not shouting, not making his voice heard in the street. A bruised reed he will not break, and a smoldering wick he shall not quench, until he establishes justice on the earth. The coastlands will wait for his teaching. I, the Lord, have called you for the victory of justice. I have grasped you by the hand. I formed you and set you as a covenant of the people, a light for the nations, to open the eyes of the blind, to bring out prisoners from confinement, and from the dungeon those who live in darkness. The word of the Lord.
Draw water joyfully from the spring.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak to those gathered in the house of Cornelius, saying, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him. You know the word that he sent to the Israelites as he proclaimed peace through Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all, what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him." The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. This is what John the Baptist proclaimed: "One mightier than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop and loosen the thongs of his sandals. I have baptized you with water. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." It happened in those days that Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized in the Jordan by John. On coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens being torn open and a spirit like a dove descending upon him. And a voice came from the heavens, "You are my beloved Son, with you I am well pleased." The Gospel of the Lord.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today we celebrate the baptism of the Lord. And with the feast of the baptism of Jesus, so we conclude the season of Christmas before entering the ordinary time of our liturgical year. For more than last 2 weeks in our liturgy, so we have celebrated Jesus as an infant. From this Sunday, once again, we begin celebrating Jesus as an adult. And therefore, today, appropriate, we begin with Jesus' first public appearance as an adult on the bank of the River Jordan for his baptism by John the Baptist. All four Gospels tell us about the baptism of Jesus by John in the River Jordan. The eagerness of the Gospels writers to tell us about the baptism of Jesus indicates the importance attached to the baptism of the Lord by the early church. Now today, looking back, reflecting on the life of Jesus, life and work of Jesus, we can imagine until the baptism, Jesus had lived a quiet, a laid-back life in Nazareth for 30 years. He was a kind of humdrum existence as a carpenter, as a carpenter's son. There was no hassling of his person. Life with his mother in their sleepy old age might have been blissful with his carpentry work. And as a young man, for him that life was, one of happiness, happy-filled days. All that was about to change with the appearance of John the Baptist making his weird and noisy entrance into history in the Jordan River. And Jesus' arrival in the River Jordan to be baptized by John in the presence of a large crowd completely, would change his life, his situation once and for all. The work for which he was sent by his heavenly Father was set in motion, inaugurated on the bank of the River Jordan. Once he stepped into those running cold water in the River Jordan and was baptized by John, his cover as common man would be forever blown away. Through his baptism, Jesus was running into the tsunami of old history. He would hold nothing back. His life would make a difference for everyone who had encountered him. From then on, up to now, billions of people would be richer by it. And God, his heavenly Father, was delighted by his decision. Therefore, he blowed out in the presence of a large crowd gathered on the bank of River Jordan to hear down through the centuries, "This is my beloved Son with whom I am well pleased." Now, this moment in the River Jordan was a threshold of experience for Jesus, a moment of radical change after which his life would never be the same again. From that day of his baptism, Jesus left behind the quiet, obscure life of a carpenter's son, hidden years with his mother Mary and Joseph, during which, as St. Luke in his gospel tells us, he grew in wisdom and grace before God and people. So on that moment of his baptism, Jesus embraced on the messianic vocation. What was that messianic vocation, the consequences of that one? Today, it's good to reflect what living out that messianic vocation would entail for Jesus. Jesus was about to launch a revolution or a kind of revolutionary movement which would turn Israel and the world upside down. He would establish God's rule of justice, peace, truth, love in Israel, and among all the nations of the world. However, he would not choose any of the ways his contemporaries predicted or his contemporaries envisaged God's rule being established with the coming of the Messiah. He would reject the policies of violent revolution adopted by the zealots, the radical, you know, Jewish movements. He would reject the easy compromise of the Jerusalem elites. And he would also reject the narrow nationalism advocated by the Pharisees. Instead, Jesus would choose the path of redemptive suffering as portrayed by prophet Isaiah in chapter 42 and 53 of book of Isaiah. We read, the suffering servant of Yahweh, suffering servant of God. So Jesus' way to fulfill the messianic mission would be to turn the other cheek, to walk the second mile, and to take up the cross. Jesus would defeat evil by letting evil do its worst to him, by suffering evil in love and forgiving his enemies. In obedience to the will of his heavenly Father, he could identify with the sinners and outcasts, with the poor and downtrodden, and exercise a ministry of compassion and ministry of forgiveness, healing and hope. This is how Jesus fulfilled his messianic mission, vocation on this earth and inaugurated the reign of God. Today, we his believers are entrusted with this mission of messianic responsibility. You know, keep going. The reign of God he inaugurated on the day of his baptism. Today, as we celebrate the baptism of Jesus, let us also recall our own baptism. Renew and deepen our baptismal commitment. We have been baptized not with the baptism of John, but with the baptism of Jesus. We have been christened and empowered with the Spirit of Christ. We have been entrusted with the responsibility of continuing the liberating, healing, and transforming mission of Jesus. We, like Jesus, must excel in our Christian life. Our lives must make difference in someone's life. Human problems, human hurts and conflicts surrounds us everywhere. As baptized Christians, we too, like Jesus, must go about doing good and living good because we are baptized in the baptism of Jesus. Amen. We'll all profess our faith by praying the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, great heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, is buried, he descended into hell. On third day he rose again from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Brothers and sisters, gathered as baptized people, we have the courage to ask for God's grace and His help for ourselves and for our world.
For our church and its mission of evangelization, may we have the wisdom to share God's love with those who need it most in our world today. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government officials, may they lead with compassion and a sense of justice in a world shrouded in the darkness of war, terrorism, and discrimination. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For all who are ill with the coronavirus, may they be healed. For the frontline workers, may they remain healthy and not grow weary. For the success of the vaccine to rid us of this pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the unbaptized catechumens and baptized candidates seeking membership in our church, may their journey of faith lead them to a fruitful life in Christ. We pray to the Lord. For our beloved dead, especially Christian Stowe, Frank Janusa, Billy Kennedy, Beverly Michella, James Humble, Robert Robbie Mayu, and Dave Clark, may they share in the radiance of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, we offer those intentions which we hold in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Heavenly Father, hear the prayers of our hearts and speak to us with your blessing so that we may please you in all we do. We ask this through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Our offertory song is number 600, Rain Down, number 600.
Brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God Almighty Father. May the Lord accept our sacrifice. Praise and glory of His name. For good end of all His holy church. Accept, O Lord, the offerings we have brought on the revealing of your beloved Son, so that the oblation of your faithful may be transformed into the sacrifice of him who willed in his compassion to wash away the sins of the world, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For in the waters of Jordan you revealed with the signs and wonders of a new baptism, so that through the voice that came down from heaven, we might come to believe in your word dwelling among us, and by the Spirit descending in the likeness of a dove, we might know that Christ your servant has been anointed with the oil of gladness and sent to bring the good news to the poor. And so the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, O Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your holy name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Holy Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he gave himself, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, His wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to His second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of the whole world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you this evening. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this earthly life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we go to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As Christ our Savior taught us to pray with confidence, let's all pray to God, our Heavenly Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And let's offer each other a sign of God's peace.
Yes, we do. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. The body and blood of Christ bring us everlasting life.
Our first communion song is number 343, Spirit and Grace, number 343.
Breathe through the field, gather the wheat.
second communion song is I Have Loved You, number 602.
Let us pray. Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly entreat your mercy, O Lord our God, that faithfully listening to your only begotten Son, we may be your children in name and in truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Baby Bottle campaign for the Women's New Life Center begins this weekend. Please take an envelope home as you leave Mass today and prayerfully consider making a donation. Thank you in advance for your generosity.
The Lord be with you.
May
Almighty God bless you all, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let us go forward. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is number 561, Sing of the Lord's Goodness, number 561.